Greetings, minions. I am your humble narrator, Sideways Thinker. And I'm just here with some more Let's Play this here Dark Souls 2 on that there PC. Sorry, I'm just trying to deal with something sound-wise, because at the moment I am suffering from the awkward condition of being functionally half-deaf. Because I basically can't hear anything out of one of my ears. Which makes it slightly awkward to record, because if I can't hear myself, I tend to shout a bit loudly and the actual recording goes a bit screwy. So, yes. However, from the sounds of it, I have the choice of hearing my voice or hearing the game. So, just gonna have to deal with, if my commentary is a bit odd in this particular video, that's why. But yes, we're going to make our second attempt at dealing with the pursuer. Come on. Come on. Come on. There you go, yep. Nope. Yep, thank you for the massive overswing. Much appreciated. Lovely. But, actually, while I'm here. Turn it down just a wee bit. But, yes, no, whatever the fuck I was saying. Have I accidentally fucking... Okay. But, yes, no, we're gonna try to deal with the pursuer. And in order to deal with that, I have not one, but two, count them two, juice bags of Capri Sun Orange. I have molding, I have rotten orange husks compressed into a liquid and then poured into two bags in front of me. Ah, Capri Sun Orange. More sugar in that than anything else. Lovely. That must be said, more of a summer fruits man, myself. Or tropical fruits. I can have the one with the lion on it, but that wasn't in the offing when I went shopping, so had to go for orange. The sacrifices we make. This is where the people who donate to me on Patreon, this is where your money goes. It's to keep me an energy drink and Capri Sun orange juice. Probably. So that's grounds to immediately reconsider supporting my Patreon campaign, that is. Just the immediate notion that I'm spending it on hideous, awful, unpleasant juice. Oh, dear. Stabby, stabby. I want to actually go walk into the pursuer's room with a decent amount of health. I'm trying to remember if there is actually any reason for me to go up here. I mean, I know that there's a guy there waiting to jump me. Because I can see him. He's not hiding from me. I'm pretty sure we could all see where he was there. And we can even more so see where he is now. Because he's not even trying to hide. He has ceased his attempt at hiding. He's now just standing directly in front of me. And yes, I've made my decision. I'm going with not being able to hear the game rather than not being able to hear me speak. It's just weird. I know that that's odd, but I need to be able to hear myself speak. In fact, I'm pretty sure that's not just me. I think I've heard that there are other Let's Players who actually have their voice playing back to them inside their headphones. I just don't really know how to get that to happen. Yeah, they have their own voice playing back to them in their headphones, specifically so they can hear themselves speak and regulate their volume compared to the game. Okay, I'm gonna get killed here. I died. I just died to a fucking halberdier. Oh, sweet Jesus, I just died to a fucking halberdier. I am doing well. I need to drink some Capri Sun. You probably hear that in the videos, okay? Just the crinkling of the empty straw packaging at the back. I've just lost like 5,000 odd souls there. Not in that particular death, but because that particular death means I can't go back to get my original pool of souls, which was like something like 5,000, something of that nature. Come on. Come on, come on. Come on, let's go. Let's go, come on. You know, it is actually quite amazing to me still how unforgiving the Dark Souls games are. Especially if you go from playing Dark Souls, or go from playing Dark Souls to playing basically anything else. You're amazed at just how accurate this game really expects you to be, and just how... I mean, obviously, a single death isn't actually that big a problem, but... still, like, a single death in Dark Souls can just happen immediately, like, a single fuck-up. In Dark Souls will quite literally cause you to just immediately lose everything, and it is rather odd how quickly this game becomes unpleasant. How suddenly failure just creeps up on you. Right. Let's try this again. Given the fact that I've got a bit of a headache, I'm quite a bit tired, and my mind is currently addled by Capri Sun, this is probably going to go poorly. Indeed, it's going poorly already. Ladies and gentlemen, watch Sideways Thinker fail at... Ladies and gentlemen, watch Sideways Thinker really poignantly not actually swing, but instead just keep raising his guard at the pursuer. Because he forgot how this game worked. Watch him die, because he wasn't paying attention. Need more Capri Sun. I think it says something about how I'm dealing with the stress of failing at this game, that so far I've had one attempt against the pursuer. I am already almost having finished my first bag of Capri Sun. Already the stress has gotten to me to such a degree that I have drained dry the shiny, colourful packaging. Yeah, fuck off, I don't care. I'm not gonna hang around to fight you guys right now. I'm busy. I've gotta go over here and try and kill your boss. I mean, I assume he's your boss. And you do work for him, right? Hi, pursuer. How are you? Whoop. Rolled in the wrong direction. Good, great. Not what I needed. Take a drink. Ow. Oh. Wow, okay. Okay. Because I can't backstab him. Because I can't backstab him, I'm just going to equip the Hide Knight Sword in the main hand, just because everything in my nature forces me to tap this instead of tapping that in order to do the attack. So if I keep it in my main hand, I should be fine. I'm not going to be fine. There is no way on this earth I'm going to be fine. I am fucking up already. I don't know what the hell is wrong with me right now. But I am just doing awfully at this game. I think it may actually have something to do with the whole problem with my ear. Because I don't know why, but I think it's because, if I recall correctly, no problems with your ears fuck with your coordination. I don't know if that's specifically my hand-eye coordination, but my coordination is some... But that is certainly fucked right now. And my judgment, apparently, also ruined. Okay, so far, this is going better. I've actually hit him. But then he hit me for most of my health. See, the way I'm used to fighting this guy involves basically waiting for the phantoms to lure him in front of the ballista here. Ah, shit. Yep. Yeah, the way I'm used to fighting this is by luring him in front of that ballista, because that ballista can... Basically, if you hit him... I'm pretty sure if you hit him with both of the ballista shots, or with two ballista shots, maybe three. One thing I can't push on down. Oh, dear. But yeah, if you hit him with both ballista shots, or with three ballista shots, if you hit him with some number of ballista shots, it kills him very quickly. We're not looking well. In the interests of having more health, I'm gonna slam a human effigy into me. And try again. If I fail this third time, this is gonna be one hell of a short video. And run! God fucking damn it! They keep catching me, and that's incredibly annoying. Hi. Don't mind me, I'm just kinda relatively casually ambling away from you. While head to toe in leather and a couple of bits of metal. Here we go! Take three! Hey, biggin. Oh, lovely, two hits. Come on. Shit, he dodged me! That's unfair. Surely that's unfair. I mean, that's gotta be cheating. I mean, he's the big, scary fuck. He shouldn't be dodging me. Okay, we've actually done a bit of damage to him now. Oh. Oh. Slow and steady gets hit with something that should have by rights cleaven me in twain. Slow and steady keeps getting whacked. Oh. Slow and steady takes a drink. Slow and steady desperately wished he just accidentally waltzed himself off the goddamn edge. Come on. Thank you. Ah, this is just the worst. Holy shit. Pretty sure that stab would have killed me. If I recall correctly, His stabbing attacks are absolute goddamn murder. Oh, shit. Life gems. What ho? Life gem, life gem, life gem. Okay, come on. Come on. Oh, we're so close. Life gem, come on. I think we can actually take him. Come on! I think he's like two power attacks away from death. Oh! Yes! 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 Oh. Oh, dear. Oh, dear. That is actually the first time I've ever beaten that guy. Like, on my own. Genuinely the first time. I've never won a fight against that guy on my own. And it was as a build I'm not familiar with. Granted, that's basically also the way you have to kill him when you're playing a strength build, because you can't really block him. He's a bit too tough to be blocked reliably, but still, that's good. Let's swap my weapons around again. Where's my hard knife sword? There you are, you bastard. And now, let's take a moment from Dark Souls 1 and awkwardly put it in as a required part of Dark Souls 2. So, this is it's a small thing, but it bugged me. The fact that this is clearly a reference to the fact that there was that nest in Dark Souls 1 that took you back to the Undead Asylum by getting the crow to carry you there. But that was like an optional extra, and it was really bloody weird, because, but it was optional. Like, it wasn't a storyline required thing, so it's entirely understandable why that would be odd. But in this game, it requires you to. Like, it's a basic part of advancing in the game, and that really grates my cheese somewhat. The notion of that being something you have to do. I mean, granted, they do. Kinda, and yes, I am just gonna eat the fucking souls, because I never, even in my own playthroughs, I never really made anything. I always made the weapons out of the souls in New Game Plus rather than a standard new game. So we're gonna level the crap out of ourselves. So back to Majula. But yeah, no, I'll grant that they did actually, I suppose, build up to the fact that you were going to get transported there by Eagle. Because it does actually show you the Eagle beforehand, so you know that's a thing. Yes, yes, I know, it's cheap for me, but even though you only sell to me, so the only thing I can really use to try and figure out how expensive this is how much you're charging me, and you only sell to me, so doesn't really have any effect. Hello, my dear! Level me up, please. Right. We got leveled up a bunch of stuff. And even though this is going to be a short video, just because I'm clearly having trouble playing this game, recording, keeping my commentary going, and just generally I'm in something of a bad mood because I'm having to deal with the fact that I basically can't hear out of one of my ears. That's going to have to be all for me for now. Being your humble website, just think it, and as always, keep calm and carry on. Good day. Well, I hope you enjoyed watching that video as much as I enjoyed making it. Well, I say that. I could have been having a really shitty day when I recorded that. You can't tell, and I certainly can't. Pre-recorded message and all that. Anyway, just here to say that I have a Twitter account that you can follow if you want occasional updates of random thoughts from me, and that if you're feeling generous, feel free to donate to my Patreon campaign. Every penny donated there makes life easier for me generally and slowly goes towards me getting a better gaming PC. Well, that's that. It's over. Leave. Now. Now!
Do not seek the sideways thinker. Do not seek the pardoner.